The 2019 ESPYs were last night, and a funny thing happened. In fact, two funny things happened, both of which really paint a clear picture for how the national NBA media, really just ESPN in general, see the Dallas Mavericks right now. One of them was an outright slap in the face, I felt like, and the other was just a joke. Like, even by their own logic, it's a joke. So the first of them, and if you're cheating and reading the whiteboard behind me, you can be forgiven. That's my fault for the layout. But the first thing to me, which is to me the little bit more disrespectful rather than just laughable, is that ESPN at the ESPYs decided they were going to honor a bunch of historic players stepping down, guys who were hanging it up. That's a great sentiment. You see it all the time. And then, you know, it is what it is. You have your Dwayne Wades and players, these great players that come through. And when they're heading off into retirement, you honor them. But there was a bizarre lack of inclusion for a certain tall baller from the G. Dirk Nowitzki completely slipped ESPN's mind. How do you have the one player who has spent more years with a single franchise in NBA history than anyone else? How do you have that one guy slip your mind? It's not like he didn't get massive appreciation tours everywhere he went this year. Every road arena he played in gave him standing ovations, whether it was at Boston, at New York, at LA, the Clippers I'm talking about in this particular case. Huge amounts of respect and admiration. Hell, San Antonio. If Dirk has one historic rival, it's the Spurs. So to give it that kind of context and then look at this and the complete just lack of even a mention in a segment in which you hear the segment name and the first two names that should have come to your mind are Wade and Dirk. But there was no Dirk. Never mind the fact that he reclaimed sixth place on the all-time NBA scoring list. Never mind the fact that he passed Wilt Chamberlain. Never mind the fact that, as I said, he reached that 21-year milestone. Never mind the fact that he dropped 30 points in his last home game, and that was an actual talking point for ESPN. And hey, look what Wade did in his last home game, and over in Dallas at the same time, look what Dirk did in his last home game. Both great, but you somehow forgot Dirk, but you remembered the other side of the equation. That is frustrating. But it wasn't even just that, because Dirk is so humble, Dirk probably doesn't even care. He probably shrugged it off like, oh, well, whatever. That's just how Dirk is. Dirk's never going to clamor for the spotlight, and maybe that makes him easy to overlook for ESPN, considering he has one championship and not multiple. He never chased rings to go elsewhere. Now, had they not won in 2010, 2011... yeah, Dirk probably does at some point move on from Dallas because he did want that championship. But once he got it, he was never leaving, and he's been clear about that. Meanwhile, you have then the breakout athlete of the year, a category in which, you know, football, basketball, whatever, it's open. It's not just NBA. I understand that. The winner, Saquon Barkley, won from the NFL, from the New York Giants. But there was a curious representation for the award. Not mentioned for the award was Luka Doncic, the NBA Rookie of the Year. Not just the Rookie of the Year, the winner of 98 of the 100 votes. Who were the two votes? The Atlanta voter, the Atlanta-based voter, and a voter from Oklahoma City who is an OU alum. Trey Young went from Norman North High School to Oklahoma. It's the two votes that he didn't get, he in this case being Luka, were obvious bias and not even serious voters at that point anyway. They were just going to vote based on their own bias, their fandom, whatever. Luka Doncic essentially was a unanimous MVP. Excuse me. I'm flashing forward into the future before my eyes. Luka was a unanimous Rookie of the Year. And in spite of that, he's not even nominated for the award. Okay. Interesting. Well, I mean, there's a lot of great breakout athletes each year. Maybe they grabbed a couple NFL players. Maybe it's just an NFL bias. And let's see here. Let's see. Let me shuffle my papers. And let's see. Who else was in here? Trae Young! Trae Young was up for the award? Trae Young. Now, he didn't win. If he had won, it would have been a complete and utter joke. But Trae Young was nominated for the breakout player of the year instead of Luka Doncic, despite the fact that in the NBA's own version of that award, Luka ran his ass out of the voting. It's absurd. It's nothing like, what's the basis of this? We hear the people who wanna discount Luka's achievements from last year say,
oh, well, he was a professional for, you know, 2 or 3 years there in the EuroLeague, so he's really not a rookie.
Man, please. He was 19 years old walking into this league. Fun fact, you know another international player who was professional in the European League and an MVP and a champion before coming to the NBA, winning Rookie of the Year, and still getting your award for Best Breakout Athlete of the Year? Pau Gasol, also the third pick in the draft, just like Luka. You didn't care then. Now, yeah, we're dating way back, obviously, in that case. We're going all the way back to, what, 2001? Yeah, it's it's absurd the hoops that you'll willingly jump through on that front. But then when it's time to look at it here in present day, you want to use the EuroLeague thing like it's against Luka. So when you say breakout, what are you talking about here? Are you talking about, like, an unexpected achievement? Okay. Well, Saquon Barkley won, but Saquon was the second overall pick, so that doesn't really hold up. I mean, second overall pick, you expect him to have a significant impact on the team, on the roster, on the league. Fine, okay. Luka is the third pick, similar thing, fine. Trae Young was the fifth pick, though. And again, I already talked about the 98-2 voting discrepancy between Luka and Trae Young heads up, head-to-head. So why on earth was Luka not even nominated? Nominated. I'm not talking about winning. I'm talking about just nomination. That's a slap in the face as well. I mean, it's laughable to do that. The ESPYs mean nothing. They're not based on objective fact. They're based on the opinion of this sports establishment, if you will. What do they feel? What do they think? Well, they're looking at Dallas, and in addition to throwing shade Dirk's way, they're looking at Luka and saying, well, yeah, he's Rookie of the Year, but, you know, he was always the favorite the whole time. So even though he had all these great moments, we weren't surprised. Therefore, it's not as remarkable to us. And therefore, we're going to somehow undercut him and his achievements. Oh, he's with Porzingis now. Fantastic. Well, we haven't seen Porzingis in over a year, and we haven't seen them play together at all. So we don't even know what they have. Danny Green, in his own free agency situation, when he talked about the Mavericks, he said, you know, they look like they're 2 to 3 years away, but yeah, guys look at it and they say, Luka and KP sound great, but we've seen 1 year of Luka, and we haven't seen KP in over a year, and we haven't seen them together. It made more sense, obviously, for Danny Green then to go to LA instead. But it's just, you look at it, and you can see around the league right now, be it media, be it players, whatever, Dallas does not yet have that respect. And I kind of get it because we haven't done anything of real note that wasn't a personal achievement of Dirk's in our post-title years. I think we've been back to the playoffs, obviously, a couple times, the last time of which was in 2016, another first-round exit. We haven't won a playoff series since we won the championship. I think we've won a grand total of maybe 6 playoff games in that time. It's been tough sledding, tough sledding. But at the same time, we have two great foundational pieces in place, but because people haven't seen them together, we haven't had a chance to actually start changing minds, and that's what Dallas has to do. I don't know. Luka seems like a pretty humble kid, but I know he wears a chip on his shoulder. He needs to load up this little bit of disrespect, throw it on that chip, that pre-existing chip on his shoulder, put just a little bit more on there, and he needs to just come out and wreak havoc in year two. Because sports media, ESPN, Fox Sports 1, they tried like hell to convince you the last 2 months of the NBA season that Luka versus Trae Young was suddenly a heated race. And many of which started saying that Trae Young had surpassed Luka Doncic for the year-end award, despite the fact that Trae Young only had a great final two and a half months, never mind the fact that Luka was phenomenal at best and at his worst was probably still very good or great. Like, the whole body of work here is more than what Trae Young had. And I'm not trying to just completely dogpile Trae Young. I think he's a fine player. I think he's very good. And was it were a year in which Luka Doncic wasn't in his way, I think he would have been your rookie of the year. Obviously, he finished second in the voting. But it's just ridiculous to me how people want to spin this and view this like, man, this is a real chase here. This is a real rivalry. This is a real competition. No, it's not. 98-2 tells you it's not. And then you pivot over here, and they're still throwing disrespect at Luka. They're still throwing disrespect and just complete lack of faith in what the Mavericks have in place. Now, I get it. Free agency did not go the way Dallas wanted, and maybe that, I mean, it's not like we knew, obviously, before free agency started who was up for these awards. I commented on this weeks ago, and only now I'm cycling back to it because of the actual event last night, the ESPYs. But it's just, it's ridiculous the level at which they want to ignore us. They won't stop ignoring us until we're back in the playoffs and we can actually get out of the first round. That's just the reality of the situation. Can we get to the playoffs this year? Maybe. I think there's a chance. It's a stacked Western Conference. I do think we got marginally better, but at the same time, it's not what we expected. It's not what we promised. And, you know, I'm going to comment later on. I'm going to do another segment here in a bit talking about some recent comments from Mark Cuban, talking about free agency, talking about Luka and all of that. And that'll give you a little bit more kind of insight into that and my feelings towards the Mavericks' performance compared to how Cuban sees it and then my reaction to what he said. And I'll play that audio clip for you. But, man, you know, like the Oscars, you look at this and you say, this is an actual stage at which you can see amongst your peers where you stand, what the perception of you is, how well, you know, it's not just about being great in this case. It's about having, it's like a popularity contest or a little bit of politicking as well. And whew, the Mavericks are getting no love at a national level right now, maybe because the perception is we want nothing but European players. And we have some unproven young talent now. But even if that's the case, man, oh man, ESPN, where the hell were you at honoring Dirk? That's just a joke to me.